Hello, everybody. It's Game Freeze here, and today we are going to some weird ones and safety ones. I don't know how long I'm going to do that, but let's watch it. Why did you do that? Oh, it charges your phone, my phone? I didn't know that. It charges your phone and this phone. That's about that. You get your phone and this phone. See, you have a screen recording and see you in that. You could try this out. That's a favorite. This is a real story to come. You know, can I count on Yahoo again? But yeah, I guess something else. This is not working. PS4. And this is the reason to go to.
There's going to be a quiz, and you'll have to show me what you learned.
No.
I looked up, and Mr. James was at his desk typing on his phone.
What?
That's when I realized that the game in Mira's text was Mr. James.
No. Okay, Ellie. This stuff does happen from time to time, but no way. It just so happens to be the same teacher that your class is in. No way.
I quickly put Kara's phone back in her bag.
Oh, God.
I was horrified. I mean, yeah, Mr. James was young and
does happen, guys.
Teachers dated high school students with statutory rape.
Yeah.
Huge trouble for it.
Exactly.
I didn't want to mess things up for Kara if she was happy. But also, what Mr. James was doing was illegal.
Yeah, because...
I finally decided to tell Ms. Edmonds, the guidance counselor.
Oh, good.
She and I had a really good relationship.
Oh.
I trust her to keep a secret and give good advice about how to
talk
to her.
She's not going
to
keep that secret.
But when I told her what I'd discovered, she said she had to report it.
Whoa.
I begged her not to.
No.
Telling her I thought our sessions were confidential.
No.
But she said confidentiality didn't apply in this case, and that
Damn.
The safety of the students was the most important thing.
Yeah, it's true. It's
I freaked out.
Wow.
If Kara found out I told, she was going to kill me.
But
Ms. Edmonds said that I could
remain
anonymous.
But
nothing could have prepared me for the events of the following weeks.
Oh,
Mr. James was suspended, and police were investigating his phone records.
Oh, no.
Kara didn't come to school for several days, and didn't answer calls or texts from me or any of our friends.
Damn.
When she did come back, she looked pale and cried all the time.
Damn.
I finally got her to spill the whole story. She said she'd been in love with me.
In
and
love?
If she went to jail, her life would be over.
No.
I just don't understand how anyone found out, she said.
Oh,
we tried
no.
to be so careful.
Oh, but it's her fault.
Inside, I was panicking. Had I ruined Kara's life? Or
no.
had I protected her?
I mean, you ruined his life, but not Kara's life.
Or had I protected her?
You protected her, trust me.
I felt like such a coward for hiding the fact that I had told.
Damn.
She thanked me for not judging her, and then looked at me and said, "You're my best friend, Gina.
Oh, Gina.
I don't know what I'd do without you."
Oh.
Now Kara's and my relationship has become really weird.
Damn.
I don't just hang out with her like normal anymore because I feel so guilty.
Damn.
She's sad all the time, and I know it's my fault. Do you have any advice for me?
Do
Should I tell
advice?
Her I was the one who reported Mr. James?
No.
I'm losing my best friend forever.
Oh, no.
I don't know how we can go on like this.
No. See, that's the thing. It's an awkward situation, man. You did it because you wanted to protect your friend.
Mm-hmm.
This is such a touchy subject, alright, because as an adult, alright, you know you're not meant to be with someone under the age, you know, because come on now, it's just taking advantage, alright? This girl thinks that she's in love with this teacher, whereas the teacher clearly isn't in love with her, alright, clearly. Oh man, this story makes me sick, just even thinking about it. Ugh. Oh man, I'm not sure that story is real or not, alright, but regardless, okay, yeah, don't get into a relationship with your damn teacher. What? It's just that simple. Alright, the next animation I want to check out is Am I Too Pretty? What? How could you be too pretty? Okay, let's not judge this girl, alright, maybe she has some good arguments of, you know, why she thinks she's too pretty.
Hi, I'm Callie.
I'm Callie.
I'm going to tell you a story that might seem a little unusual.
Yeah, you're too pretty.
I'm
what?
Really pretty. Like, beautiful.
Oh, I'm pretty. Like, I'm so beautiful. Look at me, guys. I'm so pretty, okay? My life is so hard, but I'm so pretty. Oh, my God. Okay, guys. Let's not judge her, all right? Maybe she has a hard life being so pretty, all right? It is quite hard being this beautiful, honestly.
You know that might sound like bragging, and
yeah.
to be honest, it feels like bragging.
It is bragging.
I don't always feel beautiful.
Okay.
But enough people have told me I am that I've come to believe that is how most people perceive me.
Wow, okay.
The attention I got from my appearance started when I was a baby.
When I was a baby? okay.
People would tell my mom, oh, you have such a beautiful baby.
Pretty standard.
You should enter her in contests. Pretty
okay.
normal, right?
Yeah.
People love babies.
Yeah.
But it continued when I was a toddler.
Okay.
A modeling agent approached my mom in a restaurant when I was 3 to see if
wow.
she would sign me.
That pretty,
My
huh?
mom said no. 3 was too young, she thought.
Yeah.
But the attention didn't stop as I grew older.
Okay.
And eventually, my mom was asking me if I would consider a career in modeling or acting.
Sure, why not? Since you're pretty
By
and everything.
By that time, I was starting to feel really self-conscious.
Oh,
People commented
okay.
on my looks so much.
Oh.
I hadn't even hit puberty yet. And I was already getting catcalled on the street.
Oh, no, that's not
I loved
never
math
good.
And science, but nobody seemed to care that I was good at those things.
Oh, man.
Most adults I interacted with commented on how I'd be beating the boys away with sticks soon, or how I'd have no trouble finding a husband.
Wow. See, yeah, I can understand where this girl's coming from now, I guess. Oh, yeah, because, you know, I think she feels like she's more than just a pretty girl, you know? But then again, you know, like, feel like you're more than just a pretty girl than you are. Why do you feel like being called pretty is a bad thing? You know, you can be more than just a pretty girl. I don't know.
When I was 13, I start a YouTube channel dedicated to robotics, one of my greatest loves.
Okay.
But in the comments section, people would leave comments like, you're hot, or Shay, you're not legal.
Oh, yeah, trust me, I get the exact same type of comments, No, but seriously, alright, yeah, YouTube comments, alright, they're always going to be no filter or that sort of thing, alright, yeah, alright. It is very hard to stomach this kind of stuff that some people leave on YouTube comments, alright, yeah, you need a sort of thick skin or something like that, alright.
Stuff that made me really uncomfortable.
Oh, yeah, I imagine
I started wearing baggy clothes to hide the curves I was developing.
Oh, no.
I kept my textbooks over my chest in the hallways at school.
Damn.
I started getting so anxious about when the next unwanted comment would come that I would spend breaks between classes in the restroom throwing up.
What? Throwing up? I know in some eyes, you know, a compliment is a good thing, you know, but yeah, like, I guess when you hear it all the time, it's a bad thing. I don't know, like, this story's a bit weird because, like, a lot of us, you know, like, are probably, like, jealous or angry at the fact that she's too pretty and feel like she shouldn't complain about this sort of thing because maybe, you know, we feel like that's something we want to work towards, you know. But I think the whole point in this story is showing that, you know, like, I guess, I don't know. There is a moral here. Let's just keep watching, okay?
I started showing up late for class so I didn't have to walk through the halls when there was a crowd.
Okay, damn, that
and
bad?
The other problem with being too pretty? People don't like you.
Oh, yeah, that's the thing, you know. Like, yeah, like, we're all probably thinking, yeah, we don't like this girl because she's complaining about being too pretty, all right? See, this is the thing. I guess the story is that, like, we're all, like, self-conscious about something.
People don't like you.
Aww.
Other girls think you're full of yourself.
Aww.
And guys only want you so they can brag to their friends about how they got with you.
Damn, okay.
People also don't think you're smart.
Oh.
I was the butt of so many dumb blonde jokes, even though I was a great student.
Wow, okay.
Once, my mom told me I was so pretty that I wouldn't need to worry about going to college.
Oh.
I'd be able to snag a doctor or a lawyer, and he would take care of me.
What kind of mother would say that to their child? What the hell?
That hurt more than anything.
Yeah, I mean,
between my self-consciousness and the way my classmates resented me, I didn't have any close friends.
What?
And with the way people didn't take my aspirations seriously, I started to doubt my own ability to have a career in robotics like I wanted. So I decided that if this was how the world was determined to see me, as just an object, then that's what I'd be.
No! That's the worst reaction to have! Don't just accept and believe it! No! If you know who you are at heart, then that is who you are. Don't try and you know, be someone that you're not and confined to, like, people's beliefs. Oh my god, this is so bad. Alright, yeah, I get why this animation is important to watch, okay? Yeah. You know who you are at heart, guys, alright? That's all that matters, okay? Don't try and be someone that you're not, alright?
I traded my baggy clothes for low-cut tops.
No!
Started wearing lipstick, flirted with the guys who gave me attention, even if I knew they had girlfriends.
What?
I did not care about anyone.
Wow.
I'd gossip about the other girls who I knew had been gossiping about me for years.
Well, what? How's that have anything to do with your appearance, though, okay? I mean, yeah, if you want to be a pretty girl, then be a pretty girl, but don't be a bitch. What the hell?
I stopped trying in my classes.
Wow.
A couple of teachers noticed, but I blew them off when they tried to talk to me.
Wow.
I wasn't sure if this made me happy, but I kept doing it. Perhaps because I was so tired of proving my real self to others.
But you don't have to prove your real self to anyone. This is the thing, alright? You don't have to prove yourself to anyone, okay? Just be yourself and be happy with who you are, okay? Don't try and be, like, more pretty or more ugly or whatever, you know? If you know who you are, that is who you are. Accept it, okay? Man, some people care way too much what other people think, guys, alright? And that is what I hate about society, alright? I think it's probably because, you know, of social media and shit like that, okay? Yeah, just, like, just be proud of who you are, goddammit.
I didn't stop.
Damn.
For homecoming, I wore the sexiest dress I could find.
Damn.
A chaperone told me I'd violated the dress code and handed me a sweater to cover up.
Uh-oh.
Everyone looked at me and I could tell they were shocked. Perhaps for two main reasons.
Oh, damn.
One, this doesn't look like me because that's not my style.
Oh.
And second, well, because I looked very attractive.
Damn.
However, twinges of my old self-consciousness resurfaced.
Oh,
then a guy walked by and pinched my backside.
No!
That was the last straw. I started to cry uncontrollably.
Oh,
people began to stare at me, some of them snickering and whispering to each other.
Oh.
What are you looking at? myself in my room and refused to come out. It's not like I could ever go back to school after the scene I made. On Monday, I had to go to school as my dad requested.
Yeah, of course.
I was so nervous, I threw up before school.
Awkward. Oh, drop.
I had a meeting with the counselor, who was really nice.
Okay.
I told her I knew how ridiculous and arrogant it sounded to claim I was too pretty. But she said it wasn't ridiculous at all.
Aww.
She said together we could work on ways for me to feel more comfortable being myself.
Exactly.
And for me to get back on track with my schoolwork.
Good.
But it might be a long process.
Okay.
Things are slowly getting better.
Good.
I've learned how to manage my anxiety and how to better respond to comments that make me uncomfortable.
Yes, how you respond to it.
I joined Science Club at school.
Good.
I'm finding some friends there.
Hell yeah!
I've got a long way to go before I figure out how to be happy with myself.
Aww.
But things are looking up.
Things are looking up, okay? Especially since she's still pretty. Oh man, like that. See, what do you guys think about that story? That's a pretty weird one, honestly. I mean, I can understand where she's coming from, alright? Because yeah, hearing that sort of thing constantly, where alright, and she knows that she's more than just a pretty face. You know, I suppose it could get to you after a certain while, you know? I mean, I imagine a lot of people, even right now, would probably hate her because she's even complaining about something so stupid, all right? You're probably thinking, like, first world problems, you know? But yeah, I guess we live in, like, a society where we all want to be pretty, you know? So I guess it sounds so stupid, the idea of someone thinking that they're too pretty, you know? I don't know. Very, very weird topic, honestly. I think the main moral of the story is just to be comfortable of who you are, all right? Don't pretend to be someone you're not, all right? And yeah, it's all about how you respond, all right? I don't think anyone means, like, any, you know, bad intentions by calling you pretty, you know? But yeah, I mean, I don't know. That's a tricky one. What do you guys think about that? Leave a comment, jeez. All right, the next animation I want to check out is I Hate My Crazy Rich Stepsister. Okay.
Hello. I'm Kelsey.
Kelsey.
I'm 10 years old.
Oh my god.
My mom fell in love with her boss.
Left
me and my dad.
What?
And moved into her new lover's mansion in the rich part of town.
What the? Okay, all right. Jeez, okay, you got a terrible mother. Jesus Christ. She left you and your dad, okay? I can understand that she left your dad, but she left you too? Oh, that's so sad.
I was so upset, I cried for weeks.
Yeah, what
but
the hell?
But worse than that was how devastated my dad was.
Oh, poor dad.
Years to move on from this.
Oh.
And even now, he still refuses to speak to my mom.
Wow.
He lets me spend weekends with her, but he has no contact with her at all.
Wow.
When she picks me up, he goes to his workshop at the bottom of the garden.
Oh, poor guy!
It's made things really awkward.
Yeah, I'd imagine.
Worst of all is my mom's new family.
Oh,
her new husband's kid, Zoe, my stepsister.
Yeah,
she's a total brat. She's a year older than me, and she's the richest kid in our school.
Wow. Okay.
Yep. We go to the same school. Her dad, my mom's new husband, is like a millionaire.
Oh, it's like a millionaire. Wow, so much money, yeah.
Like a millionaire.
Millionaire, isn't that much?
He buys my mom and Zoe whatever they want.
Damn.
And Zoe always comes to school wearing the latest catwalk trends.
Catwalk trends?
Everyone knows we're stepsisters. But you wouldn't believe it if you saw us together.
Well, yeah, obviously, because you guys aren't related, all right, obviously.
Not that we're together often.
Oh, okay.
Not our choice, anyway.
Yeah, all right.
She's so mean to me.
Oh, no.
I've been wearing the same clothes for years.
Oh.
My dad makes me wear them until they're basically falling apart at the seams.
Oh.
He even made us take sewing classes together.
Oh.
He thought it was good bonding time, and, well, he can't really afford to buy me anything.
Oh, this poor dad is trying his best. Oh, this man, I'm so sorry for this poor dad. Oh.
You see, when mom left us, dad refused to take any money from mom.
Wow.
Even though dad's kind of poor.
Damn.
He makes furniture for a living, so we struggle through each month.
Aww.
Sometimes, I just wish I could let my mom buy me some nice clothes.
Yeah, why not?
But I know dad would get really upset because I'd be wearing... Frank's money. Yeah. Frank is my mom's new husband.
Yeah, we got it.
Anyway, Zoe's 16th birthday was coming up.
Uh-oh.
And she was going all out.
Uh-oh.
And throwing the biggest sweet 16 bash anyone in our town had ever
seen. Lucky girl.
She even hired a band.
A band?
Rented a catwalk
What?
And some famous models were coming to do a fashion show.
What the? Okay.
The weekend before her party, my mom and Zoe were shopping for outfits.
Damn.
Dad had given me $20.
Wow.
Which I thought might be enough to buy a new dress.
That's a lot.
Zoe burst out laughing when she saw my amazing $20. Mom just sighed.
Oh.
She knew better than to offer me money now. Zoe was ranting about trying on Gucci dresses. Her dad had given her $2,000.
$2,000?
Out of nowhere, the jealous in me just started bubbling up.
Oh.
I couldn't stand it anymore.
Oh.
Right there in the fancy store, I started sobbing.
Oh.
I told Zoe it's not fair. She can have whatever she wants and doesn't have to worry about hurting her dad's feelings.
Damn.
Mom tried to calm me down, but I ran out of the shop.
Whoa.
I hated how spoiled Zoe was.
Aww.
And she was always so horrible to me.
Aww.
She didn't understand what it was like to be poor.
Aww, it's
I kept
true.
Running until I reached a cafe.
Okay.
And I decided I would just spend the $20 on lunch.
Oh, this poor girl, she spent her money on lunch. Oh, no.
I didn't need a new dress to try to impress Zoe and her stuck-up friends.
Good for you.
As I sat lost in thought eating my spaghetti, Zoe came in.
Uh-oh, Zoe's
here. What is she doing here? I really wasn't in the mood to hear about her amazing dress.
Is she going
to
say sorry?
I just wanted to be left alone.
Oh.
She begged me to come back with her to the store.
Yeah, come back.
I just finished my spaghetti and agreed.
Wow. Okay.
It wasn't worth it to argue with her. She'd just make my life hell.
Oh.
On the way back, her dad called. After he hung up, she started sobbing.
Uh-oh.
He just told her he wouldn't be home in time for her party.
Whoa.
Since the conference in New York had been delayed.
Whoa.
He transferred another $2,000 to her bank.
What?
And told her to get a nice new handbag for the big day.
What?
I couldn't understand why she was crying.
Wow.
She looked at me and said, "Don't you get it?
Oh.
You're so lucky, Kelsey. Your dad loves you so much.
Oh.
And he's always spending time with you.
Oh.
He loves you so much, he even sews your old clothes up.
Oh.
And actually enjoys spending time with you.
Yeah, he does.
I still didn't get it.
You have a great dad.
Between sobs, she just blurted it out.
Wow.
I'm jealous, okay? Oh,
she's jealous.
Suddenly, everything made sense.
Yeah.
The way she treated me, the way she spoke badly of my dad and teased us for wearing old rags.
Wow.
She was just jealous because my dad actually prioritized me.
Hell yeah.
I almost wanted to laugh. We have been so mean to each other over the past few years.
Damn.
All because of jealousy?
Yeah, what the hell?
I hugged her and told her it's okay.
Oh.
I said I'd been jealous too, and that's why I'd stormed out of the shop.
Yeah.
I guess the grass is always greener, right?
Right.
We both realized that our dads love us. They just have different ways of showing it.
Yeah.
And one way isn't more right than the other.
Yeah, you're
right. And now? Well, let's just say we're getting along pretty well.
Good. Oh. Oh, man. So, yeah, I guess the moral of the story of that is, you know, like, yeah, appreciate the things that you do have rather than focusing on the things that you don't have, you know. Like, yeah, like, just because you don't have money, you know, doesn't mean that you don't have a loving, like, father who, like, really does care for you, all right? And, yeah, like, this rich dad just gave $2,000 like it was nothing, all right? But this other dad, you know, gave $20 out of his hard-earned money, which probably means way more to him than it does to this other dad. Yeah, guys, all right? Appreciate all the good in your life, all right? Stop focusing on what you don't have and start focusing on what you do have, all right? Honestly, we are very lucky to live in this sort of world, all right? Yeah, just appreciate everything good in your life, guys, honestly. Oh, you know what, guys? That animation was really good. Okay, let's just check out just one more animation, all right? Now, let's check out I stole my dad's computer, and I was not ready for what I saw. Okay, I think we can all imagine, you know, what we found on my dad's computer. Let's check out what she found.
Hi, I'm Evie, and I've got this problem.
Okay.
It all started when I was 8 years old.
Okay.
Every Friday night, my parents would make me go to bed earlier than normal.
Oh.
So they could have a movie night alone.
Uh-oh.
One night, I begged them to let me stay up with them.
Uh-oh.
But they were saying that the movies they watched weren't suitable for kids.
Uh-oh.
He sent me off to my room.
Uh-oh.
I didn't understand. What could they be watching that I couldn't? I can be quite stubborn, so I decided that no matter what, I'd find a way to watch their movies.
No, don't watch the movie.
I didn't like secrets. And also, I was just really curious. I stayed in my room like a good little girl. And waited.
Okay.
And waited.
Oh no. Okay.
Until the house was completely silent.
Oh.
On tiptoes, I crept downstairs and grabbed their laptop before making my way back to my room.
Okay.
I didn't want them to wake up. So I plugged my pink headphones in, and lucky for me, they had just clicked pause and shut the screen.
Oh. Okay.
I rewound the movie and pressed play.
What's the movie?
My eyes were stinging from staying up so late waiting for them to go to bed. I couldn't peel my eyes away.
Okay.
I couldn't believe what I was watching. It was all about a kid who could see dead people.
Oh.
And everywhere he went, these ghosts would haunt him.
Oh, it's a horror movie.
I watched right up until the end and then ran as fast as I could downstairs to put their laptop back.
Alright guys. It was a horror movie. Alright, that's what she found. On her parents' laptop. Okay, all right. I don't know about you, but I was kind of expecting something different. What were you expecting, Brandon? Nothing. Let's just keep watching. Shut up, guys.
I've never been so scared in my life as I was that night running back to my room. I didn't even care if my parents woke up and caught me. I just didn't want the ghosts to get me.
Oh no, she's scared now.
I almost fell down the stairs in fright as my dad opened his bedroom door. I was so jumpy. I clung to my mum most of that weekend, afraid to go anywhere on my own.
Aww.
But as the week went by, I found myself craving that feeling of fear.
Oh.
I know it sounds weird, but it's like going on a really scary roller coaster.
Yeah, I get it.
Or diving into a swimming pool.
Yeah.
I just wanted to do it again and again.
Yeah, it's like playing a horror game.
Friday. I took their laptop again and searched through my dad's movie files looking for more scary movies.
Oh no.
That night, I watched two. One was about a psycho murderer, and another was about zombies.
What?
I could barely breathe when I was watching them, but I didn't care.
Okay.
I loved that movie. I had to start sleeping with my light on after that night, though.
Okay.
One weekend, my parents went away on a camping trip, and my cousin came to babysit me.
Okay.
I was so happy when I noticed my dad's laptop in his office.
Oh, no.
I told my cousin
I
wasn't feeling well and went to bed early. And I ended up staying up all night long, binge-watching a whole series of horror movies.
Wow.
I was so afraid to go to the toilet that I just went straight to sleep.
What did you pee the bed? What the hell?
My cousin came to wake me up that morning, and I was about to get up and follow her downstairs for some pancakes.
Okay.
When I noticed there was a wet patch on my pajamas.
Oh,
she noticed
herself.
Too and burst out laughing.
Oh, no.
As she walked away from me, I heard her call me EVP.
Wait, why is your cousin laughing? Isn't she meant to help you clean up this mess now? Isn't she now responsible of cleaning this shit up now?
EVP.
EVP.
I was so embarrassed. As the weeks and months went by, I ended up peeing the bed quite a lot.
Oh.
I was so afraid my parents would find out that I decided I'd just keep a bucket under my bed.
What?
And if I needed to pee after it was dark, I'd just do it in there.
What? That's ridiculous.
I also became really afraid at the slightest kind of noise.
What?
Once my mom called my name, and I actually screamed.
Oh, no.
I think that I'm super nervous and a bit weird. But despite all of this, I can't stop watching. In fact, now I'm 12 and I'm still addicted.
What?
I know it sounds silly, but I don't know how to stop myself. So far, I've managed to hide this obsession from my parents, but I'm starting to lose my friends.
What?
They don't invite me to their sleepover parties anymore because I always end up needing to sleep with a light on.
Aww.
And one time, I peed myself at Tessa's house.
Oh,
now
no.
She won't even talk to me.
Oh.
But I don't know what to do now. I know it's not good for me, but I still find it thrilling. We have a big school trip coming up soon, and we're staying in a cabin in a forest. There's no way I can get out of it because my parents already paid. The problem is, half of the horror movies I've watched are set in cabins in forests.
Yeah.
And none of the girls want to share a cabin with me because they think I'll pee the bed and make our cabin smell. I basically turned myself into a loner.
Aww.
Please help me.
Please help me.
Have any of you ever experienced anything similar?
Oh, man.
I know I need to stop watching these horror movies.
Yeah, just stop watching it.
Just don't know how to stop.
Just
please
stop.
Share your tips with me. I hate feeling like such a coward. And I especially hate being called EVP.
EVP. It's just such a weird story, all right? Like, yeah, like, your parents are just looking out for you and trying to protect you by telling you to not watch these damn horror movies. But yeah, honestly, I think just get over it. Or maybe you just get over it, like, with age. I'm not sure, all right? When was the first time you guys watched, like, your first, like, super scary horror movie, all right? I think I watched, like, The Exorcist, which is, like, this really old, scary horror film. All right, and that scared the hell out of me when I was like 8 years old, honestly. And I think, yeah, but I think just got over it, you know, because when you get older, you sort of realize that these movies are just movies and, you know, nothing's really going to happen to you. All right, what's the worst thing that's going to happen? All right, are you going to die? No, you're not going to die. Okay, it's just a movie. Okay, guys, just calm down. Nothing bad is going to happen to you, honestly. Okay, guys, that was the YouTube channel Story Tune. Yeah, be sure to check out their YouTube channel and check out their other animations. Honestly, their channel is blowing up right now.
I will put their channels down in the description, and I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to keep it good. Love you. Bye-bye.